Well, hello. God bless you today. Bishop Patrick L. Wooden Sr. here. I pray that you're having a fantastic day. The Lord is good and worthy to be praised. Listen, before I go any further today, before I invite you to meet me tonight for Bible study, I want to give a tremendous thank you. I want to give a shout out. I want to acknowledge something that happened last week that truly set my soul on fire. You made me laugh. You made me cry. You blessed my soul. You made me shout hallelujah, glory to God. My hands clapped. My spirit was lifted. Oh, I was blessed in every way. The effort that was put into making my 33rd pastoral anniversary a success, I tell you, you did not fail, Upper Room, in your effort. I want to give a big shout out to my first assistant, Elder John Amanchukwu, second assistant, Elder Anthony Wilson, and the entire anniversary committee. I wish I had the names that I could read out right now of all of these mighty, mighty workers. And I'm thinking about just calling some names off the top of my head. But if I do, I'm going to forget someone. I would just say to the members of the Upper Room, and to all of our friends out there who watch us on Facebook Live, YouTube Live, who are part of our radio audience, our television audience, friends from all over, thank you so much for showing such kindness to me, showing such kindness to my family. Oh, you blessed us in every way. You made this anniversary, our 33rd anniversary, pastoral anniversary, the best anniversary ever. And it's amazing. I said this to someone, that the members of the Upper Room, with the help of the Lord, literally do things that are not supposed to be done. Things that you just think could not happen. Our members figure out how to make it happen. And I was so uplifted and so inspired. The play, the music, and then to invite my sons back, sons in the ministry. Some are pastors, some are bishops. They're all leaders. They're men of God whom God is using. And to have the sons to come and preach at the way that they preached, pastors, bishops, superintendents, leaders, men of God, highly anointed. And I'll tell you, the glory of God fell in this place. And listen, those guys was preaching like machine guns. I mean, boom, 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 boom. The word of God just going forth with power and authority, and the God of the Bible lifted up and proclaiming courage and standing for Jesus Christ in this day and time. It was a pastoral anniversary, but it was more of a prophetic move of God. As a matter of fact, I will be coming to you soon in the not too distant future announcing a follow-up service. It won't be an anniversary service, but I'm bringing those sons back. And we're going to incorporate some daughters. And we are going to have a service or services that will bless your souls as these anointed men of God, these anointed women of God, declare the word of the Lord with power and authority. We need the word of God in a day like today. We need the Bible. We need preachers who are not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, who are not ashamed of God's truth, who want to declare God's truth, and who will do it with power and authority. You know, the gospel preacher preaches like Jesus. He preached with authority and not like the Pharisees. They didn't have the authority that Jesus had. We're not asking the devil. We're not kindly and politely asking him to leave us alone. No, we're declaring our power over Satan, power to cast out devils, power to lay hands on the sick and they recover, power to serve God even in the age of COVID-19. Power to live for Jesus and power to die for Jesus. We would rather live for Jesus and die for Jesus with our boots on than to live without Jesus on our knees pleading with the devil. The devil is a liar. The God of the Bible is God. He's in charge. And in this day and time, with all of the things that are going on in the world today, I want to encourage you. I want to call your attention to the word of the Lord, because the God of the Bible is doing great things. The God of the Bible is in charge. And I want to say this to you. I see signs of wear and tear taking place in many as a result of the shutdown, as a result of the chronic nature of this COVID-19, with all of the things that are going on in the news, we're in the election season, which is when you're this close to the elections, it's a silly season, and there are churches who are closed. With all the things that are going on, there are yet many churches who are closed, and I understand having service with Zoom, and we Zoom also. I understand Facebook Live, YouTube Live, we do that also, but nothing takes the place of the saints coming together. And you know yourself, my friends, that even you, with all, you may live in the finest home with all of the amenities. You may be able to get every station that's out there. You can watch television in every room in your house. Whatever the case may be, you even have to admit that there comes a time when you got to get out of that house. You got to get out, and you need to be around people. I was meeting with someone yesterday, a husband and a wife, and we were sharing, and I was telling them how the fact that we were meeting in person and we were sharing and ministering the word of the Lord to each other and having discussions. I said, the Holy Spirit in me is ministering and speaking and responding to the Holy Spirit in you, and the Holy Spirit in them is speaking to the Holy Spirit in me. And these things take place on both a conscious and a subconscious level. We are aware of it and we are not aware of it. The Spirit agrees with our spirit, and we connect in the spirit, even as we are having a discussion about other things in the flesh. There is something about the believer being in the presence of believers. And as a result of believers being sentenced to stay in the house, and depending upon what you're watching, depending upon the news agencies. And I want to say this to you, big tech owns most of your news agencies. They own MSNBC. They own CNN. They own ABC, NBC, and CBS. And if you notice, there's a consistency amongst these people. When you watch their shows, they keep you depressed. They keep you at home. They got you thinking that the sky is going to fall any day now. And if there's any good news, if there's any hope that there may be a cure or a vaccine or any, the sun may seem to peep through the clouds. They know how to take away your joy. Well, let me tell you something. Don't you let anybody rob you of your joy, and don't you sit there at home and go into a deep depression. I have friends who are in the psychology business, people who are spiritual psychologists, who are saved, and yet they study the mind, and they're helping people, and they're all reporting that business is booming. People are turning to the psychiatrist and the psychologist because people are depressed. And one of the things that's depressing people is that people are being locked down. I want to invite you to come to church. I want to invite you to come if you feel free. Come and hear the word of the Lord. Come and be in the presence of other believers. Now, we will be social distanced. Amen. And we are doing the things that we need to do to keep each other safe. And I think we're in our, 17th, 18th, 19th, I've lost count, week back here in the sanctuary, at the upper room, with our Sunday morning services, two services on Sunday morning. We still have our Thursday night Bible study, and there are other things going on. And the God of the Bible has kept us safe, and he is showing himself strong on our behalf. He loves you. You are not alone today. Regardless of how you may feel, I feel something, Gary. I sense that there's somebody watching this today whom the enemy has been attacking. I speak to you in Jesus' name, and I speak freedom to your mind. I speak freedom to your spirit. Matter of fact, I ask God right now to revive you. Revive, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lift that hung down head. Strengthen those feeble knees. Oh God, give them to know that it's well. It's all right that you see them. You know where they are. You know what they're going through, and that you're bringing them out. My friends, go on and exhale with me. Just exhale. Let it go and watch the God of the Bible bring you out, whether it is financially, whether it is spiritual, it can be psychological. I'm glad that we serve a God who knows how to keep our minds in perfect peace. And I tell you, the Lord has spoken to me. I've got the Bible open to where I'm going to teach from tonight. I want to tell you, I want to give it away, but I can't. You got to come out and hear it, or wait till the time tonight. And the Lord is going to bless us real good, because there is nothing like the word of the Lord. And I'll tell you this, I will say this, I'm asking God to keep me. God, don't let me turn back. Hallelujah. God, keep me saved. Keep me in you, Jesus. And I, you know what, as I close, what I'm finding and what I'm discovering about the Lord, especially during this COVID-19 and all that is associated with it, I'm finding that the God of the Bible is a keeper. And I'm finding that he's a very good keeper. The song says, let Jesus lead you. Let Jesus lead you all the way from earth to glory. Let Jesus lead you all the way. For he is a mighty good leader. He's a mighty good leader. He's a mighty good keeper. He's a mighty good doctor. He's, oh my God, he's a lawyer when you need him. He will lead you all the way. Just submit to him. Submit to the word. If you're where you can, when this goes off, whisper a little prayer to him. Thank him for his leading and guidance, and ask God to keep you. And he's going to do just that. So join me tonight, right here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. All who can and will, join me in person. All who are not ready, join me online. And we're going to have a mighty time in the Lord. And I'll be honest with you, all I want you to join me for is Bible study. That's right, Bible study. We are going to study the word of the Lord together. Enjoy your evening. See you tonight.